Okay, so this is our venture camper trailer. A couple of people have asked, can you put it on video or do some pictures? So, because we're selling it, and the reason we're selling it is because my lovely wife gets sick in the cold, so she has to be inside. So we bought this Conqueror over here. It's supposed to be top of the range or whatever. She goes in there, she's not sick anymore, and we don't have to spoil our holidays. All right. Get back to the adventure camper trailer. So, you're driving down the road and you go, hey, let's pull over for a cup of coffee. So you jump out, up to the kitchen. This has to be one of the biggest and best kitchens around. Even better than the Conqueror. So you pull this out, slide that down, brand new, never even cooked on it. Grab your kettle. Fill it up, chuck it in there, easy fitting, chuck it into the gas, done. Hot water's on its way. Knives, forks, spoons, and you put a little coffee in there and you start making it. Saucepans, fry pans, all in there. Good size kitchen, right level, sink, utilities. Water tank indicators, there's two water tanks in here. That's the front one, that's the back one. There's two batteries in here, big batteries on the other side. That's the indicator there. LED lights for cooking at night. And here we have our plates. Fire extinguisher, if you're a bad cook, like my wife. That's out the back. Anyway, we'll come around here. And up here we have an awning. This awning will actually slide up. Slides up through here, but there's some little things here, springs that push it up. You open that up, you pull it out. One person can do it, but it's always better with two. It's easy. Okay, in here we have a gas bottle, which is not there, but that's where it normally lives. And in here we have a 60 litre fridge. Easy to get to. At any time, to run around the back of the car and grab a beer or milk. Normal four-wheel drive, hitch, Anderson link plug, 7-pin. In here we have a jerry can holder, and this here is just a safety guard that protects the bottle. It's on both sides, it protects that bottle. In here, we have a shower that can be hooked up all the time. And this here just goes under here. And as soon as you turn the water on, it'll be instant shower. And that there's just battery operated, which will click and turn the gas on and start heating it up for you. So that stays in there. Also, a tap here that you can turn on, and that'll also work with that pump. There's also a tap down here that you can wash your hands, you know, if you go to the toilet and you don't want to touch nothing else, which is fine. It's all spring leaf, which is good because you can get easy parts out in the bush. It's a 1500 kilo what do you call that, axle. Up here we have a big solar panel. We have a grid where you can put or a parcel rack where you can put your bikes, your wood, chainsaw, whatever you want, and you can leave that up there all the time to set up your kitchen, your tent, or whatever else you're doing. It doesn't interfere with anything else, and you can leave your boat up there. And in here you have one of the biggest storages around, I believe. Anyway, better than the Conqueror, but LED lights. This here is a solar sheet that goes over the whole tent if you want it. I'll just throw that in there, that's an option. There's a ground sheet here which goes out the front under the tent and where you walk into the kitchen. In here, there's two big batteries. and a regulator and everything else. Down through here you've got all your sheets for the curtains or the tent and everything. And then there's another one that goes out over the fridge. It gives that a bit of shade. You'll see that on YouTube if you go check it out. Now if you come around here, this is where the bed is. So, pick this up, that pin out, which is the safety pin. Put this here, and then you just put that down there. I normally put a towel there. It stops that scratching that little picture. But anyway, and we grab our little legs. Out over there like that.